It started out in 1887 as local businessmen trying to promote their hometown.
Well, now that group is throwing a birthday party. Eric Schultz takes a look at the Greater KC Chamber of Commerce after 125 years.
This is just before Grover Cleveland came to town. They imported the president.
Grover Cleveland was president, and Kansas City was preparing to host him. This historian is poring over the minutes from the first meeting of the Commercial Club.
It was a small group that met in an office in July of 1887. We can only begin to contemplate a non-air-conditioned day on 5 o'clock on the afternoon of a summer in Kansas City back then.
Add to that the smell from the stockyards. This group in later years would become the Greater Kansas City Chamber of Commerce. Back in 1887, they were trying to sell their town to the president. On its 125th birthday, the chamber's president is still selling Kansas City. Most recently on a trade mission to Brazil.
Which was very successful, and I know it's going to produce a lot of results for the state of Missouri and for Kansas City business.
Some things haven't changed, but others have.
We report upon the advisability of admitting attorneys.
You heard right. In the beginning, lawyers weren't allowed in. They weren't considered businessmen. Membership was by invitation only. Now, anyone can join.
Kansas City eager for baseball opening.
The chamber has always been out front on certain issues, from bringing baseball to town and getting bonds passed for public buildings in the 30s to some that never die.
Our chamber is doing some of the very same things that the chamber did when it was founded in 1887. Infrastructure was a big issue for Kansas City then. It's a big issue today.
And today, like then, this group never stops promoting Kansas City. Eric Schultz, 41 Action News.
Well, the Chamber's official birthday celebration will take place Thanksgiving week in the ballroom at Bartle Hall.